For two main reasons. Why? One is the fact that these references are really old. If you see, are more or less 10 years. So I will show you some results that I got during the thesis, both the theory and the theory, and you will see also the results of the application on the SINA. So these are three important works that made the difference between the whole theory, let me say the whole theory and the new theory, that, as Riccardo said, are reported. Really interesting reading is the paper that Riccardo said previously. So let's define the concept of travel time. So that is the time that a water particle takes to travel across the catchment. So if you are considering the injection of the particle within your catchment, within, let me say, the control volume, we can define the injection of your particle and the time in which this particle is going out, so it's the exit time. And then we can consider a generic time t, which is between the injection and the exit, which allows us to define the residence time, which is the time from the injection till the time t, and the life expectancy, which is the time between t and the exit time. So basically the travel time is the sum of the life expectancy and the residence time.
Okay, just a second. This is the residence time, more or less, and this is the life expectancy.
Okay. So if we consider our domain, in this case is a catchment, my catchment. Now you are super pro in solving the differential equation. So that the water budget, we are going to see that the variation of the storage in time is equal to the input to the domain, in this case it's the precipitation, minus the output, which are discharge and the evapotranspiration. Each of these terms can be written as the integral between zero and the time we are considering. The integral of these quantities, which are S, which we called age rank quantities, because they are defined with the time t we are considering and the injection time. So t is the injection time. So we obtain the age rank quantities for each of these terms. And we pass from the bulk water budget to the age rank water budget. So now we can define actually two different PDF, so probability distributions. One is the backward probability. So you are at time t, we are looking backward to what happened in your control volume. Okay. So that's why it is conditioned to time t. So you are at t and looking backward. Okay, so the residence time backward probability is defined as the ratio between the age rank storage, so it's S T in, and the storage, the total storage at time t. And in the same time, we can define the travel time backward PDF, which is the ratio between the age rank discharge, U, and the total discharge at time T. Okay, now let's start with a more complicated equation. So here are some assumptions on the time T equals to zero. Actually, the time T is not zero, but we are considering also from minus infinity to zero, which is basically our initial condition on the storage. I will not go too much into the details of these equations because there is a world of theory behind this. But we skip here directly. So this equation, the first, is basically this, if you take the terms that we defined previously, so the travel time distribution and the residence time distribution, we can rewrite the differential equation of the storage here. And we obtain what the Dirac ordinary differential equation, in which each term is multiplied by the travel time and the residence time distributions. Now we have to do some assumption, to make some assumption. So for example, we have to find the relations between the residence time and the travel time distributions, so basically between PS, PQ, and PET. And we can, for example, assign these relations, which are called storage selection function, which basically are telling us how the particles are removed within the control volume. So for example, we can say that the cold water is leaving first the control volume, or the new water is leaving first the control volume. The new water is the last water that entered in the control volume, is the first that is going out. So once we define these relations, we are able to solve this last equation, because it is actually not a differential equation with any numerical solver. It's really easy to solve this equation. We can compute the residence time distributions, and then we are able to compute the travel times and the residence times. So we are able to know the mean residence time and the mean travel times of the water particle that entered in our control volume.
Yeah, from the historical point of view, this is a completely change of perspective, because in the all the theory of the unit hydrograph, including the geomorphic unit hydrograph, the idea was that you were assigning the probabilities, the form of the probability. Here you say, oh, we have a form of the budget, and from the form of the budget we derive the probabilities. You cannot go both the way. Sometimes, if I can find this extraordinarily beautiful paper by Andrea Rinaldo and Gianluca Bolter, is that this concept is not actually clear. So if someone like me goes to that paper and read with in mind the theory of the unit hydrograph, is completely wrong, because there is some conflict. Actually, the mind of who is reading is wrong, not the mind who wrote it. But you know, you are biased by the history you have. So in those papers, with respect to the geomorphic unit hydrograph and all the hydrograph theory, you first go to the differential equations, and then you derive the distributions. In the unit hydrograph, you first assume the distribution and then derive the budget, which is kind of the reverse.
Okay. So in general, this formalism can be applied also to solid transport, where the superscript is the substance that we are going to consider. So we can write exactly the same equation. And this is one of the most important equations too, which relates the concentration, because we are interested in understanding the concentration of the generic solute in the output, so in the discharge, which is basically the convolution between the distribution of the travel time distribution, backward travel time distribution, and the concentration in the input. So this equation is always valid.
Yeah, it looks like similar to the one I draw on the blackboard, but it is not the same, because W there is a function which is conditional on tau, explicitly or implicitly. Here is in, is conditional on t. Then, if the function is independent from t and for tau, the two things coincide. And this was the old theory. But they don't.
Okay, so we can couple the equations for the solid transport. So we can couple the two equations for the water bath, for the water bath yes, and solid transport. And actually we can derive this storage selection function, which usually are assigned to a well-fixed form. But in this case, for example, we can derive it if you have data and you, can, you are able to solve these two equations. Okay, and then what was Riccardo was saying, the forward probability distribution is when you condition your PDF to the injection. So now you are at the injection time, you're looking forward to what is going to happen to your control volume and to the water particle. That's why we call this mean response time, because it is the response to the injection. Okay, and in this case, the forward travel time PDF is defined as the ratio between the age of the discharge, again defined in t and with t and injection time, and this new quantity, which is called the partitioning coefficient, which actually is this ratio, the limit from t to infinity of the volumes of discharge divided by the volume of discharge plus the volume of evapotranspiration. So this term tells us how the two contributes of discharge and evapotranspiration are balancing your volume. And finally, thanks to Neil's relationship, we can also connect the backward and forward PDFs. So here you can see both the PDFs. So this is the backward, so it's conditioned to t, and this is the forward conditioned to the injection time. And we can relate them through the partitioning coefficient. And this, there are lots, tons of equations actually. If you read our paper, are a lot.
104 equations.
Okay. Only this topic.
Yes.
Only the one paper.
Yes, in one paper.
And the Bill Dietrich once told me. If you put a figure, you have one more reader. If you put an equation, you subtract one reader. So with 104 equations,
you lost all the readers.
But actually, it's not fantastically complicated mathematics. It's just a summing, addition, and integrals. So at the end, we have a lot of formulas, but not
some
integrals.
At the end, are sums everywhere. And let me check what was next. Okay, this was the application at the Cosina River. This was made thanks to Julia. Julia, she's over there. We went together to the pictures.
This is the area where Julia works.
Yes.
She probably put
the
yeah.
This is a small catchment near Padova.
Trento. It's more close to Trento.
To Trento than Padova.
Yes.
Trento. Okay, this is the workflow, the connection that I showed you in these days. This is the graph that we developed for the Cosina. So you see there are 37 nodes. Okay. These are the results obtained with the embedded reservoir model compared to high mode at the two different closure sections. Okay. This these are the balance of each of the components of the water budget for each of the reservoirs, so canopy, zone, groundwater, for the 5 years we considered. So we can compute the true for the evapotranspiration. We checked that we had the closure of the water budget each year. Thanks to these waterfall charts. And these are the results of the residence times, in which we assume that the storage selection functions are equal to 1. This means that there is no preference for old water or for new water, but there is a well-fit container, let me say. And here we saw that the mean residence time was around 77 days, that the residence times were increasing with time. And this is interesting, it's the partitioning coefficient that I was talking before. So this is saying that during a year, so in January, we have, of course, more discharge than evapotranspiration. And then we go into the summer and we have more evapotranspiration than discharge. Actually, it's always more discharge than evapotranspiration, but the contribution of the evapotranspiration is increasing.
Yes.
Okay. And then here is another application. Is the two same closure sections, but with the daily time step and results of daily time step. That's the results of the waterfall charts. Okay, I think that's it. Okay, this is also interesting because here, thanks to GeoFrame, you can see the different components of the evapotranspiration. So the component from the canopy, from the roof zone. So for example, in our case study of the Cavone, if you want to see something like that, you can print. You can write the output from the component of the canopy, the component of evapotranspiration, and see the two different parts of the evapotranspiration. And that's it.
That's the resident times estimated with the daily simulation, because here we were intrigued by the fact that if we were simulating at hourly time step or a daily time step with different parameters, obviously, for reproducing the things, we would not like, we would be kind of scared if the residence time produced by the model would be different. Instead of they are equal.
Okay, at least. And this is the partitioning coefficient again, so the same behavior, and that's it. All the information are about my thesis, which is available online, as all our material, and that's it. Oh, my
okay.
Actually, there's no, okay, the paper is with the question is, let me check if we have references, but you can find everything in the blog of your club.
You don't have computer for a moment,
no, but I think that, yeah, look at this.
Supporters. Somehow you know, I was younger then.
This was a Skype call when I was in the United States. No, I was in Salerno. So we were 7 in a Skype call. All men. Okay, thank you.
Are you try to find the paper?
Ah, si, sì, let me check.
You have so many papers there.
Yeah, my PhD student is supposed to read a paper a day, and the researcher too.
Guarda, le cose, if I type on Google,
EdgeRank
Dragon is one of the best research.
But you
should know, I know that
2000
is very, very
Yeah, it is 2016, yes.
But if you go on the floor.
Now we have a follow up of that paper. We are going to submit very soon, I hope.
I'm working on another paper on
leisure
time and transfer time. That is not going to be of your.
I will not like it. No. Yes, I know. That's why I'm putting. Oh no, this is. No, this is a presentation. Okay. What are you looking for? Well, if you browse my blog, somewhere you can find the place where there is all the
video. Okay, here is the theory about celerity and velocity, travel times, the velocity of travel times. Here are all the references.
Okay. We will give you the reference later.
Okay.